These barrow deeps have remained untouched for nearly 3,000 years. Still, there's no telling what creatures may have taken up residence after we sealed these tunnels shut.
There is nothing to fear in this place. The only enemy that has ever given me pause is now corrupting the lands above us. Let us be done with this business and get back to the surface.
Agreed. Just be careful. There is no telling how the druids of the Claw will react to us after all this time.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to the fifth level of the Night Elf campaign, Warcraft 3, Reign of Chaos on hard difficulty. And this is a long-ass dungeon, but very exciting at the same time because it is packed with secrets. So many secrets that we are going to be discovering. And I'm going to show you every single one that I know of. And if there are any other secrets that I'm not aware of, please point them out in the comment box so that I can be educated as well. So let's get started with this immediately. We are going to use our treants to tank as much of the damage as we possibly can. And at the same time, we are going to focus fire on this Wendigo. So now the idea for the first section of this level is to get especially Furion to level 6 as quickly as we possibly can in order to get access to his healing ability, which is Tranquility. Now there was a thing about Tranquility, it takes about 30 seconds for it to cool down. And once it has cooled down, I mean, we can almost constantly keep on healing. That's what I'm actually trying to get to. So really, really important that we get him up to level 6 quickly. Same goes for Tyrande with her Starfall ability that does an insane amount of damage. So yeah. Like I mentioned, there's quite a bit to cover in this level.
I heed the voice.
But all of the things that we do get is going to be really, really handy for the final levels that we are going to be dealing, the final level.
I sense a strange darkness tainting them. They have been transformed by a great evil.
It is going to help us out with the last level. So it's definitely to your interest to find as many of these items as you possibly can. Okay, so the creeps that we do face in this level are relatively weak. As you can see, the treants tank the majority of the damage for us, no problem. And most of them just die instantly. Not a problem at all. Oh yeah, when I forgot to mention, it was for a reason like this. Put off your fairy fire. It is not necessary at this time because the units are so weak. They will become, the fairy fire ability will be a lot more valuable in the upcoming levels. We can, however, use Furion's entangle ability in order to keep them from killing our units here at the back. But other than that, you can just put off the fairy fire and save up the cyclone ability that we are also anyways very rarely going to be using. But there are some opportunities for it nonetheless. Like keeping magic users from using their magic abilities like Blizzard. Okay, so we are... there we go. Yeah, we are nearing the very first secret, which is located right behind these trees. Need to get Furion close by. We can... Yes. So notice the seal, Jimmy the seal. And unfortunately for Jimmy, he's gotta go. And lo and behold, a manual of health that we are going to give to Furion, because Furion is the more important one, well, actually the most important one between the two to survive. So yeah, definitely. The spider ring. I forgot about the spider ring. Switch it up, give it to Tyrande, and let's move on.
Someone threatens the wild.
And yeah, we are about to get to the second secret, which is probably the most important secret out of the lot. You're about to find out soon. So destroy the trees over there. Let's deal with these spiders here at the top. And you can see he has a little path here. So take note of the massive skull over there. That's how you know that you are at the place that you need to be. And it is one of the biggest secrets. And it's like, no jokes. It really is a big-ass secret. Not just for what we are going to be finding, but also for, yeah, just stay tuned and watch.
So be it.
Healing first.
Ashrathoraman.
Something is amiss.
The goddess calls.
Okay.
I heed the voice.
Yep. Look at this mofo. Largest panda ever. He's not very tough, but he does pack a punch. So we are just going to keep our Tyrandes at the front and deal as much damage to this thing as we possibly can. As you can see, he goes down pretty quickly. Oh shit, however, don't let them be in the fray. And he's done for. Now, this is a very important section, because he drops one of the most important items that we can hope for, and that's the Necklace of Spell Immunity. Now, for if you by some chance don't understand what that means, it means that Furion is completely immune to magic. It means that when we cast our Tranquility ability, especially in the last level, it means that magic or sleep from the Dreadlords or anything on that line is going to have no effect on Furion, which for us is it's such a major advantage. I cannot even explain.
This must be what cursed the spiders.
If the corruption can do this to these simple creatures, I dare not imagine what it could do to the beasts who live above.
We must put an end to this corruption, no matter the cost.
I actually forgot to get the treants over there, but it's not a problem. We are very, very close to getting Furion's Tranquility ability. And, let's try not to lose any of our units if we can help ourselves. Perfect, perfect. One more kill, and Furion is ready. Oh, you know that we can use a lot of mana because of the Shobi Mask. That's a nice little advantage we've got, and voila. Lo and behold, the effectiveness of having a Keeper of the Grove on your side.
Someone threatens the wilds.
Okay, yeah, this area has been completed. We can move on.
So be it. Ashrathoraman, someone threatens the wilds.
Old priestess, we need your help. Our shaman was bitten by a strange spider and has become deathly ill. Our tribesmen have run off, leaving us to fend for ourselves.
What would you have us do?
The waters of the nearby Fountain of Life can save him, but we dare not leave him in this state. If you can fill this vial with its waters and return it to us, our shaman's life will be saved.
If his wisdom will prevent you from turning feral like your tribesmen, I will gladly save your shaman. The goddess.
Okay, so this is not the most important quest to complete, but it's nonetheless a neat little one to complete. We can just drop any item, we're gonna come back anyways. So let's quickly attend to this section.
For Kalimdor.
Whoopsie daisy. Whoever extended a tad bit too much. Oh yeah, we don't have to deal with these ghosts. Don't worry about them at all. Don't go too far south though, because if we go too far south. Okay, no, actually, we can, as long as Tyrande does not keep the veil. I have done that before, so that's the only reason why I'm warning you.
I need only place the vial in the fountain's waters.
What is nature's call?
I keep the voice. Someone threatens the world.
Sleep dulled my senses. For Kalimdor. Ashterodalador. For Kalimdor.
Goddess calls. I heed the voice of Elune. As the goddess wills.
The land and I are one.
Mission accomplished.
For Kalimdor.
Elune be praised, priestess. Truthfully, we doubted that you'd return. Now our shaman has a chance.
Again, I must thank you for your help. Take this talisman. Should you require our aid, it will summon us to fight at your side.
Okay, so the little item that we're given is not important at all. We anyway is not going to have space for this one. I've got a better option than using that one anyways. So moving on for now. Oh, wait a minute. Oh yeah, wait a minute. There's a little secret right over here. My goodness. This is actually a secret that I just saw. I don't know how I missed this one. This is great. So, a little bit of extra information for you guys.
For Kalimdor.
More of the reason why you should always keep your eyes open. Let's see what we find.
Something is amiss. Anudora. Pathetic wretches.
Nothing.
What threatens these lands?
Okay. Maybe behind these trees. No. Okay, never mind. That's a waste. That is completely and utterly a waste.
Ashra Thoraman. Immediately. The pathway cuts off to the south. But this doorway looks promising.
Oh no. How could I have forgotten?
What is behind this door that worries you, my love?
This door leads to Illidan's prison, Tyrande. We should go. Now.
Illidan? It's been 10,000 years. Could he still be alive? We should free him, Furion. He would be the perfect ally against the undead and their demon masters.
No, Tyrande. That beast must never be set free.
But he is your brother.
Be that as it may. He is far too dangerous. I forbid it.
Only the goddess may forbid me anything. I will free Illidan whether you like it or not.
He's one badass bitch. But yeah, definitely agree with her, considering that Illidan is an incredibly powerful demon hunter. Something that especially new players will find out in the upcoming level. Am I?
Hi.
What threatens these lands?
I'm gonna laugh at myself. Okay, no. Okay, never mind, never mind. Almost thought for a minute that I saw another secret.
Has sleep dulled my senses? For Kalimdor.
Okay, be careful with these ghosts. Because they will attempt to possess your druids. So definitely keep them at bay if you can, or just move your druids back. Oh yeah, and remember to deactivate the fairy fire that reactivates after you send Tyrande off. Oh yeah, they cannot possess the dryads because they are immune to magic.
For Kalimdor. Has sleep dulled my senses?
Okay, we are actually nearing one of the very important secrets. In fact, this is over here is one of the secrets. Right here. So it's going to take a bit of mana in order to get. In fact, there are two secrets here that we need to go through. The one is on this side, and the other one is over here on this side. So we're going to be using these treants in order to battle these mofos over here. If need be, you can just use your tranquility, but we are actually doing quite well.
Is a miss.
send these back. We don't need them. Get to the sludge monstrosity. I want to see if I can clear as many trees as I possibly can with this next one, perhaps like so. Perfect. I'm actually hoping I could maybe get this tree too. The wand of negation is not important, so yeah, mini little secret right over here, but this is not it, by the way. This is literally a time waster, I'm not going to deny it, but we kind of want to get these secrets. We've got a nice little fat army of treants going, but they're not going to be as useful for us anyways. Wish this could regenerate that a tad bit faster. Anyways, the secret that we want to get to is right over here. Get the treants, send them in, and lo and behold, some hidden allies. Some hidden strong allies, might I add. Having an Ursa warrior and two shaman on our sides, it's a massive benefit to have. Like, really, I'm not kidding. This thing is really strong and tough. Plus, he's got the war stomp, and the shaman have got their rejuvenation abilities. So, yeah, kind of want to have them on our side for the last section. Okay, you don't even have to bother going to the left side. Yeah, some undead warriors to fight, blah blah blah. We're not gonna worry about them at all. Just gonna sacrifice those. Instead, we're just going to make through to the bottom side over here. Send those in. In fact, we might have need of these guys. Send them to the circle of power over here and get teleported to a hidden location right here. Threatens these lands. So send in the treants first in order to tank as much of the damage as they can. And deal with the revenant over there. Threatens these lands. It shall be done. The land and I are one. Threatens these lands. Prepared. Oh shit. Not a problem. I was a tad bit too slow. And there we go. Rub of the Magi. Actually, in fact, let's keep the protection. And, yay, we're back.
Let me pass. The Arch Druid of the Moonglade demands passage.
Okay, we are nearing Furion's end. Well, the end of his section. And get these lot in front. Make the treants.
Turn back. You are unworthy to bask in the Bear God's presence.
Bear God's?
Lots of extra damage.
Perhaps the creature was referring to the sleeping druids of the claw. But why would he call them bear gods when they appear as I do?
Okay, we let go of the protection one because
spawn of Deathwing. I should have known that you loathsome beasts would take refuge within the flames of the earth.
We're letting go of the protection one because Furion's mana regeneration is a lot more important. So yeah, Furion can be protected by other means, and anyways, the tranquility heals him as well.
It shall be done.
Okay, let's motor through this last section.
Ah, the druids of the claw are awake already. Come, my brothers, we have much to do.
What? They've lost themselves to their animal aspects. They're mindless and feral.
In the raven's name.
The horn's call might work, but it would reach only a few of them in this part of the cavern. Something is amiss.
Okay, yeah, we're just gonna motor through this last section. We got our druid of the talon bag that we lost.
Something is amiss.
No one shall be the wiser. For my brothers.
You can play the careful kind of style and make sure that you don't bump into them. But we're just gonna go.
For
You will give up his pursuit eventually. Anyways.
It shall be done. Ashterodonov. Anudora. For Kalimdor. It shall be done.
Not gonna waste any time.
Ashterodonador. For Kalimdor. Ashterodonador.
It has begun. No one shall be the wiser. It has begun. That's a given.
What threatens these lands? The land and I are
what
one.
What is nature's call?
It shall be done.
Wrong one.
Senses.
Your
sorry, shaman. Anudora. You might ask why I'm not even bothering with these. It's because it's a waste. There's no need to concern ourselves with any of these.
And I are one.
We can maybe if we really want to take on these, but
it shall be done.
Yeah. Voila.
Shandor Stormrage. I don't know what came over us. It's been so long since we remembered who we were.
All is well, Theroshan. I have need of you and your mighty brethren once again. After these many ages, the Burning Legion has returned, and only our combined strength can drive them back.
Then we druids of the Claw are yours to command, Shandor Stormrage.
I cannot go back. Goddess grant that Furion was wrong.
Your quest is foolhardy. Even your goddess has condemned the one you seek to free.
I heed the voice.
Okay, so over to Tyrande's section, which is also going to be fine. A couple of secrets located here as well. We just need to be a tad bit extra careful when it comes to losing units, as we don't have the healing ability. But we've got other benefits like massive amounts of extra damage. Don't even waste your time with the crates over there. They contain no valuable items for us.
So be it. As the goddess wills.
Just gonna go straight
as the goddess wills.
To the section.
Speak your mind, the goddess calls.
Okay, so yeah, I'm letting Tyrande tank the damage because she heals a lot faster and of course she's got a lot more health. And then yeah.
The goddess calls.
A little bit of micromanagement in order to make sure that they don't take too much damage. I think somewhere along here there might be a scroll. Oh no, wait, actually, in fact, it is healing wards. Exactly what I'm looking for. So yeah, just like drop one of your items over there.
So be it, as the goddess wills. Immediately.
And go back.
So be it.
Now we need to go to the other side in order to get the circle of power over here. And then progress even further.
The goddess calls. By Elune. So be it. As the goddess wills. Ashra Thoraman. I heed the voice of Elune. Someone threatens.
Ah, yeah. One of the secrets is located right over here. In fact.
By Elune. I heed the voice of Elune. Ashra Thoraman. So be it. I heed the voice of Elune.
Standing guard.
Whether or not someone to use the wild.
In position.
The goddess calls. Immediately. Ash your thought on her. As the goddess will.
Speak your mind.
Standing guard. I heed the voice of a loon.
So secret is located right there. Destroy the pedestal. And Tome of Knowledge for you, my friend.
Someone opens the wire. Immediately.
So yeah, it's like I mentioned in the beginning of this level, it is packed with secrets. I'm not sure why specifically this level, but I'm guessing it's like a way of maybe giving you that extra bit of help for the last level, which is pretty damn intense, if I have to add. Yeah, we can drop healing ward. It should be fine. We need to use them anyways, so might as well go about using one of them.
The goddess calls to avenge. I heed the voice of a loon.
Think this is yes, perfect.
Someone threatens your lives. The goddess calls. I heed the voice.
Because eventually we're going to have so many units. Actually, in fact, they can all go back. We're eventually going to have so many units that we need to make another control group. That is, of course, if you keep your units alive, like I plan on doing. And they are all going to be needed for the final section of this level when we get to face up against the Keeper of the Grove, which is not very powerful, but it's his allies that make it quite difficult. So yeah, we are going to have to deal with that.
As the goddess wills, so be it. By Elun, someone threatens the wilds.
Ah, important section.
Ashrathoraman.
You will find out right now as to why.
I hear the voice of a loon. The goddess calls.
A cache of the Watcher's weapons. These should help us considerably.
Reason why? Glaive. Moonglaive. Really, really handy when we face up against masses of their forces. And we want to do some extra splash damage. So yeah, a handy little thing to have on our side. We are in fact nearing the last secret that I'm aware of in this map. Ring of Regeneration. I don't consider it to be more important than the healing wards. The Ring of Regeneration is great for Tyrande, but when it comes to group healing, no. That Periapt Vitality, on the other hand, that can be relatively important. For reasons I don't think by this time I have to explain.
Only a powerful druid could command such creatures.
Oh shit. In fact, we can let go of the one agility thing and rather go for the Periapt. And have that last healing ward in order to deal with the druid that we are going to be facing.
Make it fast.
Oh yeah, we got Loki the Dark. Not a very strong thing to have on our side, but hey, extra unit is an extra unit.
The goddess calls. By Elun.
Speak your mind.
I heed the voice of Elun.
Standing guard.
Let me see. Oh yeah. I remember. Did I, by any chance?
Someone opens the wall, waiting on you.
Oh yeah. We don't have to come to this section. It's not necessary. But if you want to get some goblin landmines, you're welcome to come to the side. It's Look, the goblin landmines are awesome and everything, and if you use them incredibly well, then yeah, that is really great for you. But I never find any use for them, to be honest. So I just don't bother. And now we're going to attend to the very last secret. Head to the circle of power, located over here. And then go to this room. Yeah, so we can go for the mantle of intelligence if we really, really want to, but you can call me full of shit, but yeah, the healing ward might play a little bit of a more important role. What we can do actually is keep one of the watchers alive that we are fighting, and then just quickly have Tyrande running back in order to go and pick up that item. That is what I would recommend to do. You don't want an item like that to go to waste. Even though Tyrande is a agility main character, it's still a handy little item for her mana regeneration.
As the goddess wills, so be it. Immediately.
Make it fast.
Speak your mind, Ashthoraman. I hear the voice of the Luna. As the goddess
Make
wills.
It fast.
Ashthoraman.
I am sworn. Standing back.
The goddess.
I am sworn to revenge.
Someone threatens the wilds.
Speak your mind.
I am sworn to
revenge.
The goddess calls.
Make it fast.
As the goddess
Hold, priestess. This place is forbidden, even to one such as you. There is a terrible evil here that must remain chained beneath the earth.
Illidan was considered a great hero once. I believe he will become one again.
Madness! You would doom us all by freeing the betrayer.
Focus on killing the smaller ones first, and then you can just completely focus. Ah, shit. Then focus fire the Ancient Watcher. And Tyrande on her own is more than strong enough to take down this druid. Come on, don't. Come on. Oh, no. Not just yet. And do it now. Perfect. And that's mission accomplished.
Illidan, is that you?
Tyrande, it is your voice. After all these ages spent in darkness, your voice is like the pure light of the moon upon my mind.
The Legion has returned, Illidan. Your people have need of you once more.
Because I once cared for you, Tyrande, I will hunt down the demons. But I will never owe our people anything.
Then let us hurry back to the surface. The demon's corruption spreads with every second we waste. Furion.
It has been an eternity, brother. An eternity spent in darkness.
Illidan. You were sentenced to pay for your sins. Nothing more.
And who are you to judge me? We fought the demons side by side, if you recall.
Enough of this, both of you. What is done is done. My love, with Illidan's help, we will drive the demons back once again and save what is left of our beloved land.
Have you even considered the cost, Tyrande? This betrayer's aid may doom us all before the end. I will have nothing to do with this.
Alright, so there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. That was level 5 of the Night Elf campaign. We have only 2 more missions to go, and then this magnificent game comes to an end, and then we make our way to the Frozen Throne campaign. As always, if you like this video, please like and subscribe. Refer to your friends that would like to learn more about Warcraft and how to beat this game on hard difficulty. And I will see you next time, where we get to experiment with the mighty demon hunter, Illidan.